Sorting team here. I'm CyberWarrior486, and this is my very first Slayer map. Well, it's really meant for big team battle, just because it's so big. Just like Hemorrhage, or Blood Gulch, as some people would call it. And it's just really big because it's divided into Spartan versus Covenant. So a lot of these like themes are from Oakley High Def and the Halo Forge Epidemic. Yeah, and thanks to them, because I really wouldn't be able to do this, all the aesthetics, because I'm not really good at aesthetics, and just pretty much almost every single idea, except for like maybe a few things, were from them. All like pretty much the aesthetics were like under here, as you've seen the video where the rockets were. That's what they did. Pretty much, yeah, a lot of everything was on here. The base I'm standing on right here, that was, I guess that you could say that was mine, because I kind of redid their base. And, whoa, just got sputtered. But, let me know what you really think on this map, because I'm really nervous to see what you think on this map, because this is my very first Slayer map. I've never made one before, besides, like, going into the Coliseum, putting a checkpoint down, putting a sniper rifle down, and having, like, a sniping competition. That's pretty much the only Slayer map I've made so far. So let me know if this is good for my very first one. And you see here, I'm just failing. And hurt myself. Failing. Again. And, later in this video, I have to cut it off, because this is a 15-minute game type, and I'm gonna put this on my file share, and I recommend using 10 minutes on it, and I'm gonna also put the pelican on a 10-second kill barrier, because there's a guy camping with the energy sword right behind the teleporter, so I'm trying to prevent that from happening, because I go in here like 2 or 3 times and I get sorted. So I just could have put a kill barrier in there, and I'm probably gonna have it on my file share later today with the fixed version. Right now it's just a messed up version, but the kill barriers, I had one complaint about that the Banshee, where you fly that Banshee, it flew straight right when you're going over the Covenant dropship, like the ones you see in Firefight, and kills you, I guess. I don't know, it glitched out and put a kill instead of soft kill, because I know I put soft kill on it. And I'm just really nervous to see what you guys think. Oh, this is my very first map, and I know it looks terrible compared to, like, other maps. So, the main theme is Unicy. I guess you could say it looks kind of like Halo Wars, kind of, because, and I think one mission of it, Well, forgive me if I say this wrong because I haven't played it in like a couple months, maybe a year. And it's just really, I think it really looks like it because one mission in it, you're stationed there and you're just getting supplies and you actually have to do it yourself, I think. You have to actually play in first person. I'm pretty sure that you can do that. I'm not sure though. Don't quote me on that because I forget, and that was a long time ago. So basically, that's, and you have to actually rush the Covenant. I think it's the part where someone gets stabbed right beside you, and you're at a big, giant wall, gate, door thing. I don't know. But I think all my friends say though, it turned out really good. But I don't know. I'm just nervous to see what you guys think about it. Even though it looks one-sided, it looks like there's more stuff on the UNSC side and less stuff on the Covenant side. Well, the reason why there's less stuff, I try to split the money up equally. So the UNSC took about 4,500, so about 4,500 cash credits, whatever that's called, to build it. And the Covenant side actually took about 5,000. And I had to spend like 1,000 on weapons and vehicles. Yeah, and that's equals up to 10,000. So, well, not to 450, whatever. But I tried to actually make it because the Covenant actually took more because it was using decorative pieces. And there was so many decorative pieces that it actually wasted my money more. So that's why there's not that much stuff on their side. And plus the Covenant, it's more like they don't have buildings. They really just like, they're just outposted. No buildings at all, except for their outpost for their army. So, in the UNSC, they're actually human, so they actually have to have a place to live and get ready, prep for battle. So that's why that's more one-sided, more aesthetically pleasing than the other side. So, and all the aesthetics, I think the aesthetics turned out great because they're pretty much from Oakley High Def. And I think, yeah, they're pretty much from Oakley High Def and X133, I believe. I'm not sure what his gamertag is, but I think it's Hunter something. And pretty much, ooh, the Covenant was winning on it. See, that's what I was talking about, the random kill barrier right there. I don't know why. But in this game, the Covenant was actually winning. The Covenant team was actually winning. So I'm actually quite surprised because the UNSC has like more stuff, but the Covenant is like more overpowered because they have more variety of different guns. So keep that in mind, even though their base is smaller, they have more powerful weapons and stuff. So keep that in mind because you gotta be some pretty strong fighters if you want to fight for the UNSC. So that's pretty much all I have to show you guys today. I'm coming out with the jumping map soon, so keep that in mind. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.